Attorneys very often need to bill clients for expenses that relate to their specific case. We will refer back to the purchases in the previous video, where March 25th we wrote a check to Staples for supplies, and March 28th we wrote a check to the post office for stamps. Not all postage and supplies have been used up yet. We will do the same thing as the prior two videos, except we will mark the item as billable, because it's so simple to select them at the moment that you make an invoice for that client. And you're going to see that in a moment. For example, let's imagine on April 12th, we used $80 more of the supplies purchased on March 25th. But this time we're actually going to mark it as billable to Alan RB, the client. Well, all you have to do is reopen the March 25th check and allocate $80 of those supplies to Alan. The method I'm using to find the check is opening the trial balance, then opening the bank account and looking at the March 25th check. But if you watch the supplemental videos, there are several methods or several ways that you can find the March 25th check. Now, we have to decrease the main amount up here by $80. So $250 minus $80 in America is $170. Notice QuickBooks will if you keep pushing the tab key on the left of your keyboard, QuickBooks will know the remaining amount that's different from adding up to the top, and it will put that remaining amount on the next row. Of course, it still supplies expense, but in this case, it's specifically for the Alan RB job. Let me move the window up higher a little if I can. Now, by default, when you choose a job, QuickBooks automatically places the check mark to the right and assumes that this will be billed to Alan. Of course, don't forget to put in the memo field the date it was used. Okay, used April 12th. And of course, you'd put in whatever other information you feel is necessary in the memo field about using those $80 worth of supplies. Click Save and Close, and then click Yes. Let's do the same thing for the event on April 17th. Use $65 of stamps purchased on March 28th with this receipt, but this time it's for the Betty Boop client case. No problem. Let's open it up the way I did. Find the check on March 28th. Now, we're going to reduce this. I'm going to make it as high up as possible. We're going to reduce this by $65 on the top row and then put $65 on the bottom row for Betty. So in America, $175 minus $65 is $110. So we put $110. Now on the left side of your keyboard, keep pushing the tab key till it goes to the third row. When it goes to the next row, QuickBooks knows the amount of $65 will balance out the transaction and make the bottom add up to the top. Of course, it's still postage expense, but in this case, it's specific for the Betty Boop job. And of course, QuickBooks will automatically place the check mark as billable. And of course, in the memo field, don't forget to put the date it was used. Used on April 17th, or I believe it was April 17th. Yes, okay, and that's all you have to do. Now click Save and Close and click Yes, and those two costs are sitting somewhere waiting to be placed on an invoice. So now where are the unbilled costs before you place them on the client's invoice? The answer is the unbilled costs by job report. From the main menu, click Reports, Jobs, Time and Mileage, Unbilled Costs by Job. And you can see this is the $20 from the check on March 25th that was used, we can even expand this, used on April 12th. Okay, we'll expand this a little bit here. Okay, and this is the check for March 28th and only the $65 used on April 17th. And it says the cost by client, and it says everything else about the check itself. And you could always use this report to double-click right on the check to see what was used and when. Now, as soon as you place any of these costs on an invoice and actually bill the client, once you save the invoice that you place the cost on to bill the client, that cost is going to disappear from this report, the unbilled costs by job. So, let's imagine on April 20, we made invoice number 8 for Alan Arby. This is for legal services that were rendered, and the amount of the legal service fee is $900. It is on this invoice that we will include the supplies that we used on April 12th for the Alan Arby job. The pop-up message is how you find and place the unbilled cost. You will see it as soon as you choose Alan Arby for the invoice. So, from the icon bar, we click invoice. Make sure you put the date forward to April 20 of 2017. Now, notice the proper account is unearned because at this moment, Alan Arby has a negative balance. Look what happens at the moment we choose Alan Arby. We get this pop-up message, which is a normal part of the process. It's not a mistake. It's giving us a choice to include unbilled items onto this invoice or exclude them. We will leave the default set as selecting the unbilled cost and click OK. When you do that, the Choose Billable Time and Cost window opens up. Now notice, we have no items that we need to bill Alan for. We have no time or mileage that we need to bill Alan for, but there is one expense. When we click on the expense tab, we get the unused supplies that were used on April 12th for $80 billed to the Alan Arby job. If there were more unbilled expenses, they would all be listed here down the line. But because this is the only one, we have to go to the left margin and click the check mark to tell QuickBooks this is the particular expense that we are going to bill Alan for on this invoice. When we click OK, now notice we have used April 12th, $80 of supplies. Now, all we have to do is click on the next line, choose the item fees earned, and put the money amount of the fees earned exactly the way we made the invoices in earlier videos. So now this invoice will be a total of $980 to Alan. $80 will be the unbilled cost and $900 will be the actual fees earned. When we click save and close, we can open up the profit and loss by job, and you will notice something. You will notice that for the Alan Arby job, supplies expense has gone down to zero. The expense for that client goes down to zero at the moment that you bill the client for the expense. That's because QuickBooks says you don't have this expense. The client paid for it. And now notice the total income from Alan is $1,900. If we double click this total, we see it's for two invoices, the original $1,000 and the $900 that we just made. Now let's imagine on April 22, we made invoice number 9 for Betty Boop. These are legal services rendered where the value is $400. And on this April 22 invoice, we will include the stamps that were used for the Betty Boop job on April 17th. So we do everything the same way. But remember, postage expense for Betty Boop is going to decrease by the amount that we actually bill to her. So we open the invoice window and we go forward to, I believe it's April 22. April 22, and the money amount is, the money amount of the item is, Actually, the money amount of the legal fees is $400. Now look what happens at the moment we choose Betty Boop. The normal pop-up opens up asking us if we want to select the outstanding billable time and cost. If we agree, we click OK, and notice we don't have anything to bill for Betty except this one expense, the postage used on April 17th. If there were several, we would have to select the right one. But now it's easy, there's only one. We click in the margin to place the check mark, and when we click OK, QuickBooks has placed this on the invoice as an item that we're billing for Betty. So now this invoice is a total of $465 that we're asking Betty to pay, $400 are legal services that we rendered, and $65 are costs that relate to that legal service. When we remove the email, when we click Save and Close, notice Betty Boop no longer has postage expense related to her job because it's part of the invoice, which is included in this total $1,600. This is the invoice that we put on the $65 of legal expense of postage expense. Now, the last thing you need to see to make sure that everything is fine, you should reopen the report Unbilled Cost by Job, and notice now that we've placed every billable cost onto the invoices for clients, there are no more unbilled costs by job.